Hello everyone and welcome to another technology tutorial by Pixamoo. My name is Marius and today I'm going to turn you into SharePoint news publishing experts in the space of about four videos. This first video looks at publishing news posts in SharePoint, and then in the following three videos we're going to look at posting and managing news links, which are slightly different to news posts. We're going to look at how we can configure a basic news feed in SharePoint. And then in the last of the four, we're going to go full throttle and we're going to actually build a complete corporate news service. This series is going to be particularly relevant for you if you're a corporate communications professional, but even if you're just looking to make the most out of your team's SharePoint intranet site, then this video and the following three are still going to give you a lot of value. Before we get stuck into it, I know that about 99.6% of you watching this video are not subscribing to my channel. If you do find this video useful, could you please hit the subscribe button for me when you're done? It'll really help me keep this channel moving along nicely. All right, let's get stuck into it. So before we start posting news, there's one little thing you need to know. News posts are the same as pages in SharePoint. If you've never built a page in SharePoint before, I suggest that you go and have a look at my video that teaches you in about 20 minutes how to build an intranet page in SharePoint that'll look a lot better than your average intranet page. I've linked to it below in the description. Now, news posts, the only difference from pages is that they have a metadata field called promoted state attached to them behind the scenes. If that field has been set to the number 2, the page that you're making will actually be included in the news feed of your site and throughout SharePoint. You don't need to worry about that metadata field. All you do need to do to get started is hit the new button up here on the site that you're publishing from and then go and click news post here. When you click that button, you get this template selector tool coming up. You can select from three templates that Microsoft has provided, being blank, visual, and basic text. Now, I like to keep my news posts very simple and clean because I don't want anything to distract from the message I'm trying to get through to my staff. It's worth noting too that if your organization has templates pre-made for their own intranet, then those templates will show up at the top here. So anyway, let's go with the blank template and hit create post in the bottom right corner. That'll bring up this blank SharePoint page, and all you need to do now is fill in a few things like a page title, pop in a header image, and some text. Now there's my headline. Obviously that's a terrible headline. You want your headings to grab their attention. Now, if you're posting on behalf of yourself, that's great. Just leave your name there. If not, say you're posting on behalf of the CEO or a developer named Henrietta, you can pop their name in there instead and the news post will appear to have come from them. With the header, you have the option to configure it however you want. You can go for the plain look, image and title, color block. In our case, I'm just going to go with the overlap because I think that looks pretty good. I'm going to go here to change image and I'm going to pop in an image. It's very important if you have a header with an image that you actually pick one. Otherwise, that gray placeholder image will be the one that is showing for you. So we'll just go and find a stock image courtesy of Microsoft that is looking suitably corporate. How about that one? Excellent, and I'm just going to use the image focal point tool to sort of set that right in the middle of the watch there so that that one always displays whether it's here on the page or on a mobile device or the thumbnail for this page. I'm going to close the title area again, and then in the text web part here, I'm just going to pop in some placeholder text. If you want to put in more things like images, dividers, quick links, YouTube videos, you can do that, but like I said, I prefer to keep my news posts as clean and tidy as possible so that I don't take away attention from the message I'm trying to get out. Once we're done with this and the page looks ready to go, you can either hit save as draft. That puts it into view mode. It won't have gone live yet, so if I go back to the home page, there's nothing now in the news feed. To get it to go live, we have to hit the post news button. So to get back to the page, I go to the cogwheel and site contents, I go down to site pages, and then in the list of pages created by myself, we have some fantastic news. That's the story that I am about to put out. If I wanted to make some quick changes before I publish, I'll just hit the edit button and do what I need to. Otherwise, I'll hit the post news button and off it goes. Now, take note of this little pop-up window here, which says that you're about to publish your news and make it visible on your site, on the SharePoint Star page, and anywhere else news from this site is distributed in your organization. This is where the differences between pages and news posts are starting to become very important. When you publish a page, it actually doesn't go anywhere except that it goes live on your site, but then you have to manually add it to the menu or anywhere else you want it to be accessible from. Whereas when you hit post news here, a few things will happen. First, anyone who has access to your site, global sales in this case, will be able to go and see this news post. So if I go to the home page and then refresh it, you'll see now that that news post has shown up in the news web part that was on the home page here. There will be a couple of other things happening too. The news post will start showing up eventually in my news here. It doesn't always show up straight away, but eventually, after a few minutes, generally, it will start showing up in your news list here. And it will also be on the SharePoint Start page. There you go. Now, anyone who has visited your site fairly frequently, or if they are following that site by clicking the star either here or on the site itself, like that, anyone who follows the site or has frequented your site will generally see that news post in their news feed. It doesn't matter if they've just been at a different site. If they go to the start page, they'll see it. The same thing applies if they have a mobile device and they've got the SharePoint app installed on that device. They'll actually even get a push notification saying that we have some fantastic news. Now pay attention to that actually, because that push notification, that will go out as soon as you hit that post news button up here. So if you realize after hitting that post news button that the headline was actually not that great, it's too late to change it as far as that notification goes. So you want to make sure that whatever you publish is right. If that means asking for approvals and whatnot from your manager, CEO, or whatever, do it. It's even better if you actually put it in a Word document and just send it off and get them to email you back with their approval so they don't have to stuff around with saving drafts and then giving them addresses because they might not even have access to see that news post. Another thing to keep in mind too is that, like I said, anyone who has access to the site will be able to see that post. And that does include your CEO. So you want to make sure that whoever sees it is going to be happy with what you've put out there. So there you have it. That's our first news post done. If you liked this video, hit the subscribe button for me. Like I said, it'll really help me keep the channel going. And if you've never actually published a SharePoint page before, then I encourage you to have a look in the description for the link to my video, which talks you through how to publish your first SharePoint page and make it look better than your average intranet page. Thanks, everyone.